Okay, so let's see how you can detect transfer function from a state model. We know about the equations x dot is equal to ax plus bu, y is equal to cx plus du. Okay, here I am considering y is single output, u is single input. Now initial condition also I am assuming equal to 0, that is x 0 is equal to 0, that is for transfer function. We know that initial conditions, we don't take initial conditions in transfer function, that means we assume it to be 0. Now if you take the Laplace transform, this is the Laplace transform if you will take of these two equations. First equation will become s of xs, since it is a differentiation, s of xs is equal to axs plus bus plus bus. So taking xs on one side, xs and bus in one side, so xs will be equal to bus divided by si minus a. Si because a is a matrix, so identity matrix is multiplied with s here, okay, in the denominator. So this will be first equation, and if you will convert this equation into Laplace, so it will become ys is equal to cxs plus dus. This should be d. Now you plug the value of xs from here to here, so you'll get cbus divided by si minus a plus dus, and you rearrange it. Us will be taken common, and in the left hand side denominator you will bring it back, so you will get ys divided by us is equal to c si minus a inverse b plus d. Okay, this is very important equation. Whenever you have to obtain transfer function from a state model, you just have to take a b c d and calculate this value, that will give you transfer function of the corresponding transfer function of the state model. Okay, so we are going reverse from state model to transfer function, and this initial condition will be always be zero when you will be obtaining transfer function. Okay, so c si minus a inverse b plus d, these are vector and matrices. Okay, so it is in that form, they are not scalars. We will see examples as well in this.